My favorite stories were always the ones where the hero dies at the end. Would have been nice to think I'd have a decent funeral, or even a wake, of a wife, or a friend, or an enemy to mourn my passing. Began on a Monday. It always does if you're a pessimist. I was drinking off a hangover. Little project I'd been working on for a couple of years now. Scotch. Neat for breakfast. That's me. Dick Nicely. Alcoholic. Registered voter. Private investigator.
Good morning. Are you Mr. Nicely?
That's what it says on the door.
Well, I don't quite know where to begin.
Well, why don't you take the weight off those high heels and tell me your name, sweetheart?
Thank you. It's Brigid Levin. Well, Brigid Astor.
Lady doesn't know her name.
Levin is my husband's name. It's awful. I think he's having an affair. An affair. Do you know what that's like?
From which angle? There. There now.
I apologize, Mr. Nicely, for my lack of composure.
Oh, I think you're composed just fine.
What are your rates?
Well, you'll get a day's work for a C-note, plus a bonus should I attract any, violence.
Oh, my husband's not dangerous.
It's an unpredictable world, Mrs., Brigid. And men become dangerous when it comes to, beautiful women. Now, let's begin with the beginning.
Well, it all started 2 weeks ago.
The dame spun a sordid tale, the kind they have in those housewives magazines. She had a husband, a man. To untrained eyes, a regular working Joe. Started coming home late, spending a lot of cash, eating a lot of salad. I watched him cook a pile of books and waited for the heat to make him thirsty. I was already there. A Some private eyes choose this line of work for the danger, others for the loose women. I didn't. I like to watch ordinary people do ordinary things. Loose women, well, they were just an occupational hazard. Loose women in danger.
New car?
Old car. New corpse?
Well, it's not who you think it is.
And who do I think it is?
You think it's Ricky Russo Jr., but it ain't. It's just another one of Carter's henchmen. Tell you it'll be like this going back and forth until they find the kid.
He's probably shacked up with some dame.
Yeah. Well, Daddy tears the whole city apart.
You still at the post, Ken?
Yeah. You know they put the crime desk up against the showbiz desk? Some city.
You said it.
I don't understand, Mr. Nicely.
There's no mistress. No bimbo. No cheap rod on the side. There's no affair.
I recognize the other man.
Boss Carter. What exactly do you know about your husband's work?
Joe doesn't talk about it. Lately, he's been carrying around a briefcase. When I ask about it, he tells me to mind my own business. Some husband.
You know who Russo is, though? Russo Jr.'s disappeared 2 weeks now.
Yes. Of course.
The smart money says if they had a body to fingerprint, Carter's fingerprints are the ones they'd find.
You don't think Joe's mixed up in all that?
Joe?
My husband.
Oh, yeah. I don't know. Where'd you go last night?
I wrote him a note. Then I booked a suite at the Bryson. I'd already given up on the marriage. It was built on a lie, Mr. Nicely.
Dick.
Dick. I couldn't stand it any longer, so I had to do something about it.
You did something about it, after all this time.
Once I decide what I want, there's no compromise. Never imagined it could be like that, Dick.
You should see me with twins.
I think I know what's in the briefcase.
I was wondering when you'd get to that.
What do you mean?
I mean, it's been waiting at the back of my mind, right where you left it.
I think it's cash money inside. Enough to start over.
Read that last page for me again, sweetheart.
Think about it. You and I. Some island or a small town where we don't have to pretend anything to anybody.
Sounds tempting.
You don't trust me.
You're champagne for the eyes, my dear. But I don't trust anyone.
Well, trust is overrated.
So is a case full of money. Hey, I'm finished with that.
Fine. Fine if inertia is what makes you happy. But I think I could make you a lot happier, Dick. It ain't my place to say, but you sure could use the money too.
I'm used to a certain standard of things.
Yeah, I knew this game. Sure as I knew the aces. The broad knew how to make a deal. Husband has a case full of money. Fella gutsy enough to rob him gets the cash and the wife. Gets freedom as far as he can run. And running is something I've wanted to do for a very long time.
Hello, Mr. Cotton, Mr. Levin. My friend here says you can help me. Take a seat.
Didn't I bar you from this dump nicely?
We just ended up on the wrong foot, is all.
Or maybe you're looking for trouble.
Or maybe I'm looking for whiskey. Neat.
Know anything about that guy?
No.
Which one?
All of them.
Regulars?
Occasions. Never together.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means it's time to move along nicely.
Hey. My tab's still good around here?
Don't make me chuckle.
Penny. This begins to feel like old times.
Are you feeling so morose about it? Why don't you cry into your scotch?
It's watered down enough, don't you think? Hi, fellas. Need the soap?
Go wash your hands nicely.
Hi. Just like everyone else's.
In the mood for eggs and toast nicely?
No. But I'll take a small brandy and a cigarette if you got one.
That was just to soften you up a bit nicely. Don't choke on your teeth.
I'm sure you fellas are aware this kind of business is frowned upon.
And what do you know about our business?
I know someone's taken interest in it.
Who?
Female, seductress, habitual liar. Likes jazz, maybe.
Well, we would like to talk to her.
Let me go and I'll set you up.
Yeah, sure. We'll just let you go right now.
Well, I can't set you up with her from here, so it looks like we've reached an impasse.
You know all those smart words, don't you, nicely? Maybe you ought to open a bookshop.
Speaking of which, Joe, you do the books for Carter here or for Mr. Russo?
Keep asking questions, nicely. We'll put that rope around your neck.
Yeah, well, maybe I can help you with the knots. See, my daddy, he was a sailor. And my mommy, she could bend her fingers backwards.
Thank you.
We have the case, Dick. What's turning that smile of yours upside down?
Your husband. Russo's bookkeeper. Not Carter's. Makes me curious.
Curiosity killed the cat.
Yeah, and the tortoise beat the hare, but I don't buy that one either. Take your drink, and then you should go.
Go where?
I don't know. Back to Joe. For a few days anyway.
But we have the case.
Yeah, we have the case. And they know I took it. We can't just both disappear at the same time.
And how do I know you won't just run away with the money?
Who would I spend it on? Anyway, I got everything I need for a while.
That's the second time you've let me walk out on you nicely.
Yeah, well, I got a lot of bad habits.
You know what happens to creatures with shells, don't you? Other creatures turn them over to watch them squirm.
That moment, it came to me like a 12-year-old moat. Levin had a mean left hook for a numbers man, and no diamond ring to break the skin. Didn't know what was waiting for me then. I do now. I love a perspective from up here.
Side of the store, mister.
I was just congratulating,
Skylar.
Yeah, on the show.
This is Ricky Russo.
Junior, I take it.
I shoved it.
Did you send her flowers?
Flowers.
A congratulatory note. Skylar, care of the box office. First, get out of my club.
What if, I want to send you flowers?
Well, the name is Brigid. Same address.
What if they go to the wrong Brigid?
I am the wrong Brigid.
You can't talk to him like that. Don't you know who that is?
I know who he had his hands on. Let's begin at the beginning. When you know your nature is considered immoral by polite society, you learn how to embrace society at arm's length. Skylar could hide from anybody in a crowd, but one on one, it was all she could do to hold herself together. She needed a safe place.
Thanks. What about your best side now?
Did you call anyone else?
No.
Anyone see you standing out there?
No.
Unless they saw you from their peephole. Whose place is this?
It's his pied à terre.
He didn't get the keys from someone else for the night?
If he did, he brought his own mail and photographs for dressing.
How did it happen?
He brought me up for a drink and then he got fresh.
And?
And then he got fresh.
So you let him get fresh? Don't you know who that is?
I told you who that is.
So don't come up to his place for a drink, thinking he wants a drink. And don't drink.
When people talk about the perfect murder, they mean the perfect getaway. And that's the hard part for a man to get right. But any housewife could tell you how to do it. She may even have a plan ready and waiting for the right opportunity.
Deeper.
Don't disappear. Don't do anything different. Just forget about me for a few weeks.
Forget about you.
My husband works for his father. Forget about me. Just don't forget to remember me again.
Skyla kept her distance. I played the supportive wife. When Ricky didn't come home, Rousseau Sr. thought Carter had him killed. He killed two of Carter's men. Carter retaliated. The war began.
Hello?
Brigid, have you heard the news? What's going on?
Sorry. I think you've got the wrong number.
Brigid, please.
Coffee, if you want some.
What are you doing, Joe? Did Rousseau tell you to-
Just self-defense. This will go on, baby. They will kill each other until someone gets to me.
Well, they won't stop at you, sweetheart.
Thank you. The point is to draw a line under it. Before it goes that far.
The chump started his own investigation. Used that accountant's brain of his. Would have been easier if he'd just gone out and shot somebody.
Thank you.
I've been over that night 100 times. I'm tired.
You didn't take a taxi together. You didn't buy a pack of smokes. You didn't call anyone. Nobody saw you.
You were the only one that saw us. I miss you, Brigid. Why haven't you fixed this?
Picture tells 1,000 words.
And a song paints a picture. They haven't got you on the crime beat anymore, Ken?
Sure. Crime and showbiz got merged. I guess they figured I was going to be talking to a lot of the same people.
Musgrove! Your coverage of this tit-for-tat murder spree is a shambolic squandering of ink and parchment. 10 days into an apocalyptic, shameless blood feud, and you're still trying to get more commas and content, boy! It's a mockery of our readers' patience and of the Industrial Revolution that made print journalism economically viable! Don't you try and look me in the eye. I want you out on the beat where the cops don't dare, and I don't want you back here filing copy until you've got spent bullet casings in your shoes. And more, there's a boy out there, dead in a ditch, or holed up with some harlot. I don't know where he is, that's your story. Hitch a ride with the hoodlums. Reload their Tommy guns for all I care. You just find that boy! Don't just stand there listening to me talk, get on with it!
Your husband picked him up. Said you needed them for publicity. I wasn't gonna say no to him.
Oh, good.
You sure looked beautiful.
Hi, honey.
Thought you hated that old thing. Makes you look like an accountant, you said. You always take your ring off when you go out to do business.
I have a high opinion of you.
And so you should. What do you carry around in that anyway? A sandwich and a dirty magazine.
Honey, did you ever meet Ricky Russo?
Did I ever meet him?
Did you ever see him in person?
I don't think so.
He spent a lot of time at the club.
Probably. I wouldn't know.
I found something. Put an end to this violence. It wasn't Carter who killed the kid.
Joe, if Rousseau knew you were running around looking...
He won't know. I cannot tell I dug this up. Somebody on Carter's side has to show him.
Well, if it comes from Carter, Rousseau won't believe it.
Baby, I've got the whole thing. Who Ricky went home with. Statements. People who knows the girl. Saw her acting funny this last week. Rousseau puts her under the light. She will talk. He just need good enough reason to grab her. I'm looking out for us, baby. I have to look out for us, don't I?
Of course you do, honey. Of course you do. You better be selling something.
Don't talk to me like that. You slipped up.
You slipped up first, remember?
How did Ken miss us in the photograph?
I got in the way. Didn't have the same effect on my husband.
Well, you better get in the way again.
Skylar, you ought to run. You ought to see what this old town looks like up from the hills.
I'll run if you run with me.
I'll come find you when it's safe.
You're the running type, not me. Where'd you split from before you wound up here, huh? I could never get anywhere without you. You were there for me when it counted. You were there, remember?
That's when I found you in the phone book. The rest you already know, or can't extrapolate. I'm sure by now you've opened the case. Maybe you forgave us. Maybe you'd have let us get away with it. But we still need a fall guy. We need to tie it off. The police will find my husband's gun. Carter will blame Rousseau Sr. Hordro will blame them both. And the case will disappear. Skylar and I will be free. My favorite stories were always the ones where the woman outsmarts the men. There ain't many. This is one.
Сюда, стой!
I didn't exactly endorse the dame's plan. But as long as I was out of the picture, I didn't mind seeing her free and clear. Somewhere far away from here. Singing, maybe. Because where we were going, we had all the best tunes.
Moving in the night, listening to memories, choosing in the half light. I miss you. Please, please play at ease. Through the mountains of my heart, moving in the night, street lights and alleyways losing my starlight, lost in dark. Please, please play at ease, guide me through the mountains of my heart, losing, choosing, listening, moving in the night, street lights and alleyways, losing my starlight, lost in dark.
Scene 2, take 6,
shot 1. Scene 5, shot 16, take 3. Action.